Amen. So when we talk about what can we do for the Lord, amen, we can give him thanks.
Amen.
And we can declare his goodness. Hallelujah. And hallelujah. And it says in verse 3 of Psalm 107, and gather them out of the land from the east and from the west, from the north and the south. They wandered in the wilderness in a solitary way. They found no city to dwell in. Hungry and thirsty, their souls fainted in them. Then they cried unto the Lord in their trouble, and he delivered them out of their distresses. And he led them forth by the right way, that they might go to the city of habitation. Oh, that men would praise the Lord for his goodness and his wonderful works to the children of men. Amen.
Amen.
That's something right there.
Amen.
That's the least we can do.
Amen.
That's the least we can do is to give God thanks and thank him for what he has brought us out of.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Brother, amen. He done kept us from more than he done brought us out.
That's right.
I believe, amen, he done kept us from a lot that we had no idea.
Oh, yeah.
Hallelujah. But he kept us. Praise the Lord. Amen.
Lord.
Hallelujah. And so we thank God and we give God the praise and give God the glory. Let's pray tonight. Father, we thank you. We love you. We give you praise and glory for all that you've done, all that you're about to do in this place. We thank you tonight. We just love you, Lord. We appreciate you for what you've done. And we thank you, God, how you moved in this house and you favored this place, oh God, with your presence and with your power. And we thank you, Lord, that you are a providing God. You are God of provisions. We thank you, Lord, that every need shall be met. We thank you, Father, that we release our faith.
Hallelujah.
In the area that every need shall be supplied. Father, we release our faith that you are our shepherd and we shall not want. We release our faith, Father, oh God, that you said that we shall be blessed and highly favored. We release our faith tonight, oh God. Hallelujah. That none shall suffer lack. But all needs shall be met according to your riches and glory by Christ Jesus. And so, Father, we thank you tonight. We pray for our messenger as he comes to share the word tonight. We thank you for your saints that have gathered in this place. That we give you the glory and give you the praise. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. We thank God tonight. Hallelujah. For what he has done. Hallelujah. In this place today. Hallelujah. We give God praise for Bishop Brown and Lady Brown coming to bless us. And he blessed us with a tremendous word on this morning. Praise God. To challenge us to, amen, to grab hold to the effectiveness of the word. Amen. Praise God. So we thank God for their visit. And we believe that they have safe passage back home.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. And I pray that they are close to getting home now if they're not already there.
Amen.
Amen. Praise God. But we thank God and we give him praise for today.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Praise God. We're getting ready to yield the floor to our messenger tonight to give us the bread of heaven.
Amen.
Amen. Tonight. Amen. Amen. Praise God. And we thank God. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Come on, praise the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord. We thank God that we have the opportunity to be back in the house of the Lord once more.
Amen.
Amen. We count it special and a privilege and an honor to be able to be called in the number. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. He is faithful to his people, And as Pastor said, we ought to just give him thanks. Amen. Amen. I mean, there's no reason why we should just hold on without giving thanks, because he is worthy. Amen. He is more than worthy. Hallelujah. I look over in the land of the living, I see that David, as he said, I had fainted unless I believed to see the goodness in the land of the living. Amen. Hallelujah, because it is so much that's happening, but he is yet blessing his people. Hallelujah, he is yet blessing his people. And we thank God for today. Praise God for the message and the message of today. Hallelujah, that our house was blessed today with the presence with Bishop Brown, that tremendous word. Amen. Praise the Lord, the effectiveness of the word. Hallelujah. We thank God for him and thank God for everyone that's a part of this great house.
Amen.
Hallelujah. I won't be before you long tonight, but I want to share a brief word. We know that what was for this morning, what was for the day, was for today. But what we have now is for now. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. I want you to, if you have your Bibles, we'll ask that you would turn to the book of Matthew. This is familiar ground. Chapter 5, verse 13. You have heard this scripture before. Hallelujah. But God will give it to us in multiple ways, and others will say it come and give it in its appropriate time. Hallelujah. Matthew chapter 5 and verse 13. Hallelujah. How many of you love the Lord?
Amen.
And how many of you know that if we just keep holding on to his hand, he will continue to bless his people?
Amen.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. So again, Matthew chapter 5 and verse 13. I'm going to read it down about verse 16. Amen. And I tell you, preachers normally will get up and say, I won't be before you long tonight, but I mean it tonight. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. I mean it tonight. Because I believe the Holy Ghost, it doesn't take long to get the word of God in the house. Amen.
Yes,
hallelujah. Praise the Lord. So in verse 13 of Matthew chapter 5, verse 13, the Bible reads, it says that ye are the salt of the earth, but if the salt has lost his savor, wherewith shall it be salted?
Yes, sir.
It is thenceforth good for nothing, but to be cast out and to be trodden under foot of men.
Yes, sir.
Now verse 14 says, ye are the light of the world. A city that is set on a hill cannot be hid. Neither do men light a candle and put it under a bushel, but on a candlestick, and it giveth light unto all that are in the house.
Uh-huh.
Verse 16, let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. We'll pray. Father, thank you for the reading of the word. Thank you for your word, Father. We believe that, Father, right now, as we pray, as we come together, that your word shall accomplish every intended purpose. It shall not return void, but accomplish every intended purpose, Father, reaching your people right where we are. Father, in the name of Jesus, we pray that nothing that we do for ourselves, but we do for the edifying of you. And Father, we thank you, Lord, and we give you all the praise that you would give them the heart, the ears to hear what you are saying in this hour. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. I just want to share a brief word with us tonight. Here in verse 13, it says that ye are the salt of the earth. But if the salt has lost its savor, wherewith shall it be salted? I want to say for the purpose of title tonight, let your presence be the difference.
Come on now.
Amen. Let your presence be the difference.
Amen.
How many of you know that there are opportunities, there are times where we can come into a situation, but we miss opportunities to give our part. Amen. And this Bible here, what Jesus was telling, he was giving this sermon, and he was letting them know that if you are the salt of the earth, you should change the situation.
Yes,
hallelujah. Whenever you come into a situation, you should be the difference.
All right.
Amen. All right. Now, there are times where, how many times if you go on to eat a dinner, mm-hmm. and they brought out a plate, it looks wonderful.
All right.
It smells good.
Uh-huh.
It's presented all beautiful. It has all of the trimmings and the fixings.
Uh-huh.
But when you taste it,
all right.
you bite into it,
yes, sir.
And it did not have any flavor.
Amen.
So I don't know about you, but I am one that will say, take it back.
Yes.
That did not satisfy me.
Yes.
See, so how many times, and on the flip side of that, how many times have you been in a situation where the situation was conducive, it was right there before you, but you did not make a difference? The Bible world is telling you, take it back. Because you didn't do what you were supposed to do.
All right.
I want us to be mindful, and I said I'm not going to be long tonight. The Bible said that we are the salt of the earth, and we should have a savor. We should be the flavor in the savor. Amen.
Amen.
We should be the flavor in the situation.
Amen.
Because if you and I can't make the change, then what good are we? Listen to what the word says, that it has no effectiveness. Amen.
Amen.
He said, if it's not, it's good for nothing.
Amen.
It's good for nothing. Our witness should be that when we come in, that we are an atmosphere changer. When we come into an area, we should be one that will change the way things look, the way things sound, the way people feel. But if you don't have that effectiveness and you've lost your savor, you're good for nothing.
Amen.
I'm not trying to be hard on the Christian body, but I want you to understand our mission is greater than what we look like.
All right.
Right.
Our mission is greater than what we sound like.
Right.
But there should be something about you that will change the situation around you.
Right.
Hallelujah. And in other words, when you walk into an area, the face should light up.
Amen.
It shouldn't just be dead as normal and business as usual when you come around.
All right.
See, because if you don't have the savor and the flavor when you come into the situation, then you will begin to be as bland as those that are around you.
All right.
Hallelujah. Come on, we are the salt. We are the salt. We are the salt of the earth. When we speak, our words should manifest a result. Amen?
Amen?
It should be given a result of God in the presence of me. Hallelujah. And I want you to just know that it goes on when it says that ye are the light of the world. Saints, I want you to know that we should let our light shine.
Yes,
Lord.
When we stand before men, our story should speak volumes. If we are the salt of the earth, when we stand before the people and stand in the midst of the world, that we should not look like the world, but we should be the light that shines above all.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. See, how many of you know that when you are, we need to have the reflection that reflects Christ in the eyes of those that see us.
Amen.
When someone looks upon you, you should have the look like Christ.
Right.
As we said earlier about the likeness, he was talking about the nest. We should come into the situation and change it merely because we are the chosen.
Amen.
You are the redeemed.
Amen. Yes, sir.
You have been called out of the darkness into the marvelous light, but he's called you for a reason.
That's right.
Amen.
Hallelujah. And I want to reassure you tonight that if you are the salt of the earth, that means you are important to the world.
Amen.
Come on, somebody. Amen. Not just by mere words, but you are important to the situation that's at hand. Because God, we are the oracles. We are the mouthpiece. We are the reflection of Christ in the land of the living. Somebody say glory.
Glory.
And every time you and I, saints, come up on a situation, don't leave that situation the same way as you approached it.
Amen.
Amen.
How many times have you had you feel in a situation someone needed prayer and you didn't do it?
Come on.
How many times have you had a call to go to the hospital to pray for somebody, but you decided to stay at home?
Right.
See, your salt has no effectiveness if you your say your flavor is not effective staying behind the lines. Amen?
Right.
See, your salt has no affection if you're cooking your soup or cooking your dinner. It has no effect if you have it still sitting in the cupboard.
That's right.
Come on, somebody. How many of you? We don't want to be in the pantry. Amen? We have to be out on the counter being used. And every once in a while, it takes two or three shakes of us to get it right. Amen? Come on, somebody. See, it's not just one hit quit. It means you need to continue the good work so God shall be manifested in the world. Amen? Hallelujah. We should be light of the world. We should be light of the world. You don't want your stance to be that you're good for nothing. But the Bible says over the Proverbs right there said, a good name. A good name. It is better than riches. And favor should be worth more than silver and gold.
Amen.
See, when you are in the midst of God's people, that should be a shine upon your life. There should be something about you that says, if this person has the light of the Lord upon their life. You shouldn't come into the world and stand in and blend in. See, remember when Peter was around the fire, Peter could not blend in because he had stood with the Master. He had slept with him. He supped with him. He prayed with him. He labored with him. But at the time of his denial of him, he was cussing folks, telling them to get back, I'm not the one. But it was still something about Peter. Because Peter was the rock. He was Jesus' rock. He established the church with Peter. There was something different about him. So let's not count ourselves out because we have a bad day. Let's not count ourselves out because things are not going the way we think it should every day. But ye are the salt of the earth. And in your walk for Christ, you should make the difference. You should make the difference by speaking what thus say the Lord.
Right.
You should make the difference by praying when necessary. Praying without ceasing. You should make the difference when someone comes before you to always have a word to give to someone. Hallelujah. But now and then, you're not going to always feel good in your body. But I want you to reflect back to this word and be all the light of the world. Hallelujah. And you got to let your light, and it says down in verse 16, let your light so shine before men.
All right.
Before men. Not let your light shine behind closed doors. Right. Not let your light shine in your own secret place. But let your light shine before men.
Amen. Right.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
If you are the son of the earth, you have the opportunity to put flavor in the situation. The situation shouldn't be bland, or should be dead, or should be falling off because you didn't take the opportunity to do what you were supposed to do. Hallelujah. If you had, in other words, the salt should be available on the counter. When something is being prepared, then that you should have. How many of you go to a restaurant and sit at the table? Not only do they cook it with the salt, but they have the salt shaker and the pepper on the table. You ought to be on the table that when someone needs a word from God, you're able to take a sprinkle right at the table. Come on, somebody shout glory. Hallelujah. You are the salt of the earth. Hallelujah. Let your light shine. Take every opportunity to praise God. Let someone know that God is your God. Jesus, he is taking our love. He's taking us all for himself. Hallelujah. Yeah. Not just me. Not just you. But all men. He hung on the cross that all of us may be saved. Not one group. Not one just one somebody. But all men. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I just stopped by tonight to encourage you. You're more important than what you are looking like.
Come on now.
We can look like $1 million, but if you don't speak the word of God, you have no savor or no favor. You have no effectiveness in the situation. God is looking for someone who is not afraid to stand up and be counted in the number, to speak a word over his people, to pray breakthrough, to pray for healing, to pray deliverance, to pray that all are saved. See, if we're not doing that, it says you're good for nothing.
That's right. That's right.
We're good for nothing.
That's right.
I don't want my stance to be I'm good for nothing.
All right.
Amen.
What will you say? What will you pass on? And so many times as preachers, I preach many funerals, and people get up here, and someone's stretched out, and they have to give a story. They have to eulogize. What will your story say about you? What will your story say about you? God wants you to know this, that you're precious to him.
That's right.
You are precious to him. Jesus was trying to let them know your mission is greater than what you feel like or look like or sound like. The mission is greater because I have brought you unto me.
Yes, yes.
I need you to understand you have to be effective in the land. Let my presence resonating you. I can hear the master saying that. Let my presence show up when you show up. When you step into the room, I'm already standing there with you. You're not alone, hallelujah. You are shining because you are part of the Most High King. And when you are attached to him, everything that you touch becomes blessed. Come on, somebody shout glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Thank you.
I just want to share with you today that your salt should not be a weak season. It should not be weak and hidden. But it should be flavorful. It should be right up front present. You should be someone that's readily and able to speak and change the situation. Hallelujah. Because there are people right now that are going through a situation that does not have the strength that you do. They don't have the testimony you do. They don't have the witness you do. Therefore, ye being the salt of the earth, you should give them a little hope by telling them about the one that saved you. Tell them about the one that delivered you. Tell them about the one that made you free. Hallelujah. Somebody shout glory. Hallelujah. We're salt of the earth. Salt of the earth. Salt of the earth. Our flavor should be the changing factor in every situation. When you walk in a room, someone ought to say, it's something about her. It's something about him. When you talk, there's something they ought to say. It's something about him.
All right.
It's something about her. Oh my God. I just feel a light when you come around. I just feel a presence when you're in the midst of me. I just feel like when you speak, I felt a little better in my body. When you talk, I felt a jolt in my spirit. See, when you speak up, when you being the salt of the earth, when you stand in a place, someone ought to feel the presence of the Lord.
My
God. Hallelujah. Verse 16 said, let your light so shine before me that they may see your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven. Saints, I want to tell you something. We are required. We're needed right now. The saints of God is needed right now. Your faithfulness is needed right now.
Right.
Not just in the confines of these walls, or the confines of this wall, but we're needed in the world. It says that you are the salt of the earth. The earth is not just contained in this building.
All right.
Come on, somebody.
All right.
Somebody on your job need prayer.
That's right.
Yes, Lord.
Somebody in the hospital need prayer.
That's right.
There's a situation going on right now that needs you. Hallelujah. I'm almost done. I just want to get this in here tonight. That you need to let your good works be seen of men.
Yes, sir.
Come on, somebody. What does that mean, y'all? It means that whatever you do for the Lord, someone ought to see the manifestation of God. It should see the blessings upon your life.
Right.
It shouldn't look the same as the world look. It should look like you are blessed. And I can see that you're blessed. I can see you seem to be highly favored. And your words says to me, I am blessed.
Right.
I am highly favored. But I want you to understand that where I am, you can have it too. Because he didn't just die for me. He died for you too.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Glory.
Hallelujah. Our God is able.
Yes.
But he wants us to come a little higher.
Yes,
Lord. Come on, say it again. He wants us to come a little higher.
Yes.
So too many times we are sitting on our hands. We're getting comfortable with just coming and sitting on the pew. We're getting too comfortable with just coming and listening to the word. When you're getting feel and a touch in your body, but you're not going out and telling someone else about, thus say the Lord.
Right.
Come on, somebody. Being the salt comes with a requirement.
Yes, it does.
It comes with provisions.
Yes.
You can't do any and everything just like the world.
Amen.
Amen.
It means you need to change for a positive cause.
Amen.
For God.
Amen.
To glorify our God which is in heaven. Our Father.
Yes.
Which is in heaven.
Yes.
So saints, as I come by tonight, like I said, I wasn't going to be long. But a message that I want to give out is this. We are needed.
Yes.
You can pray right now for someone that's 200, 300 miles away.
Yes.
You're needed.
Yes.
You can pray for somebody that did not show up tonight.
Yes.
you're needed. You can go to someone and pray for them over their body who can't even speak, who may be in a comatose state. You're needed. Because you are the salt of the earth. Hallelujah. 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 And it says that if you're good for nothing but to be cast out and trotted under the feet of men, that is not where you want to be. Come on, you are above and not beneath. You are head and not the tail. Come on, somebody. You got to know that you are the redeemed. Let the redeemed of the Lord say so. Hallelujah. Let's stop drawing back when we have opportunity to be the savor and flavor to change the situation. Hallelujah.
Come on, sir.
My God is able. He has blessed us far too much to sit on our hands and not speak the name of Jesus. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. I don't want to hear people walk around me talking about there's another way. I don't have to pray all the time. I don't have to go to church. Well, if you come up around me, guess what you're going to get? You're going to get the word of the Lord. Hallelujah. When you stand in the presence of Elder Williams, you're going to get prayer. You're going to get the hand of God. Because I'm going to tell you what the book says.
All right.
Because I believe in the living word.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The Logos and the Rhema.
Yes.
The written and living word.
Yes.
I believe.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Somebody better shout glory in here.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
So don't miss an opportunity to change the situation that's needing you and I to help in that realm. Amen?
Amen.
Because the world is sick right now. The devil thinks he's winning. He didn't realize that. He knows he's defeated. But he has to know that you're active. Come on, somebody. He knows he's defeated. But if you're not active, you look like just the world. Why would he give any care to you? Hallelujah. But many are falling because you and I, someone of our stature, who has been blessed, who say we're blessed in highly favored, say nothing. Do nothing.
Come on now.
Hallelujah.
Glory.
The effectual, fervent prayer of a righteous availeth much, right? We believe that as we pray, something's going to happen.
Yeah.
And we pray, manifestation happens.
Yeah.
When we pray, healing happens.
Yeah.
When we pray, deliverance happens.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Yes,
when we pray, bondage is broken.
All right.
Yes.
You got to remember Paul and Silas at the midnight hour. When they were in the jail, in the prison cell, they didn't sit quiet. They prayed and sang praises unto God. And when they heard it, there was a quaking of the earth, and the jail flew open, and everybody's shackles were broken. Somebody shout glory. You have to be the difference in your situation. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
It's not about what you look like or feel like.
Yeah.
You press your way.
Yeah.
It ain't about how you feel today.
Uh-huh.
Your mission to the Great Commission that we're part of is still moving.
Uh-huh.
You get up off of yourself.
Uh-huh.
Get out of yourself and move and change the situation.
Uh-huh.
Amen?
Amen.
Just a little talk with Jesus makes it right.
Uh-huh.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Uh-huh.
And every little thing that you do to tell somebody about heaven.
Yes, Lord.
All God's work is being performed in the land of the living.
Yes, sir.
Hallelujah.
Right.
How many of you believe that today?
All right.
God is looking for a true church.
Yes.
A church of true worshipers. Those who believe that when we call on his name, things are happening.
Yes.
Things move.
Yes.
All things are possible to those who believe.
That's right.
Hallelujah.
Glory.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
I'm done for the night. I told you. I know the Elder Williams, everybody know he's long-winded. I go, but tonight, I believe God has showed up.
Yeah.
I believe something has been said that will help us in our week, help us in our days, to carry forward. We're coming to a conclusion of a new year.
Yeah.
We're coming to the beginning of a new year, but the conclusion of this old time.
Right.
But guess what? It's not over yet. It's not over yet. Morning is coming. You're salt of the earth.
Yeah.
You're salt of the earth.
All right.
Let your light shine.
Mm-hmm.
Come on, saints. Let your light shine.
Yeah.
And not just our 2 or 3 or 4 and no more, but there's others that need you and I to tell them the truth. To give them the good news that Jesus lives. See, the truth of the fact is this, saints. The devil is real. Hell is real. But Jesus is coming. Did you hear what I said? He's coming. Somebody say he's coming. And all you have to do is continue the good work and keep representing who saved you. Hallelujah. Be the salt of the earth. It was a message from Jesus himself. Ye are the salt of the earth. But we have to let our savor, the salt loses its savor. You're good for nothing.
Amen.
Let that not be our stance for God. Don't let that be the what people see of us, that we're good for nothing.
That's right. That's right.
Amen.
You ought to tell them that my God is able.
Yes, he is.
For my God I live. And for my God I die.
Yeah.
And I believe that everything that has breath, come on somebody, need to call upon the name of the Lord. Because I want you to understand that we are caught up in the number.
Yes.
And you have to be confident in that. Be confident that I'm in the number. And I want others to come with me. Don't just get your seat on the plane and feel I'm good, but you want somebody else to come enjoy paradise with you. Hallelujah. Come on, somebody. I want others to ride on there and come enjoy paradise with me. Hallelujah.
Oh, yes.
That's at least that's how I see it in my mind.
Jesus.
I don't want nobody left behind. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So, saints, as I take my seat tonight, be encouraged.
Yes,
do look just a little bit more. Because you are the salt of the earth.
Come on.
You have to go, let's go a little higher now.
Yes,
we've been on this plateau for so long, praying the same prayer. We say, I'm coming up. No, let's stop all that. Let's go a little higher. Nothing wrong with that. But let's go a little higher.
All right now.
Let's go a little higher.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Yeah,
praise the Lord. Nothing wrong with that.
Yeah, Lord.
But it's time.
Yes.
It is time because the devil is not taking a break.
Uh-huh.
The devil's not taking a blunt break. He's not taking a step back. He's charging at the saints even more.
Yes.
He wants to tear down the church. Come on.
Yes, Lord.
Come on. Let our Savior be effective.
Amen.
In the land of the living. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. That's all I have for tonight. God bless you.
Amen.
I pray the word has touched someone and that your week may be made called blessed. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Praise
the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Praise
the Lord.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
God for a tremendous word on tonight to challenge us concerning our responsibility, basically who we are. Amen. We are salt.
Yes.
We are salt. Hallelujah. We have a responsibility to give to the world what the world needs. The world needs salt.
Yes.
Amen. So we thank God tonight for a tremendous word to challenge us. Every day, amen. Every day salt. Every day salt. Praise God. We're not just not salt for Sunday. Amen. But we need to be, you know, because if we just come and just be salt to each other, amen, somebody's going to be too salty. Amen. Amen. The saints don't need the salt.
That's right.
Amen. The world needs the salt.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
Yes, sir.
And so we have a responsibility to salt the world.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. If you're too salty, folk can't. They can't partake of you.
Amen.
Right.
Amen. You're too salty. Praise God, but that is a tremendous word, and we have an obligation daily, amen, to be mindful that we are salt, and sometimes we pass over opportunities to sprinkle on somebody,
amen,
praise God, somebody need a sprinkle, praise God, of salt, and in their lives, to be a blessing to them, and everywhere we go, amen, every step,
that we take, amen, we ought to be releasing salt.
Amen.
Praise God, because people need that.
Yes.
They need a word. They need
amen.
Encouragement.
Amen.
They need light.
Yes.
They need hope. Amen. That comes through your saltiness.
Amen.
Amen. Praise God. I'm reminded of the little figure that's been around for hundreds of years on the salt box, the little girl
Martin.
With the umbrella, you know, and she's releasing salt as she walks.
Yeah.
Amen. Without even knowing it.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. And we don't have to be salty intentional.
That's right.
Amen.
That's right.
Just be salt.
Yeah.
Naturally. Naturally. Amen. Amen. There are things that are naturally just salty.
Yes, right. Yes.
Amen. Praise God. God created them to be that way. There's different salts. Amen. There are different salts.
Mm-hmm.
There is a kosher salt.
Yeah.
There is sea salt.
Yeah.
Amen. There's salt that has less iodine in it than others. Amen.
Yeah.
There's different color salts.
Yeah.
Salt is just all not white.
Uh-huh.
There's a yellow salt.
Yes.
There is a black salt. There is a kind of a pinkish color salt.
Mm-hmm.
And they have different distinct flavors.
Yes.
Amen. So all of us, we bring our flavor. Amen. And add it to the world, and the world will be a better place.
Amen.
Amen. A better place.
Yes.
So we thank you, Elder, again,
amen,
for a tremendous word,
amen,
to challenge us. And we know that sometimes we get caught up into our daily activities and we fail to realize that we have to take the time out to be salt in somebody's life.
Yes, Lord.
Amen. Even when we don't feel like.
Mm-hmm. Come on.
And sometimes the only way to get the salt out of the shaker, it has to be shaken.
That's right.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Is that right?
Yeah.
That's why it's called a salt shaker.
That's right.
You are a salt shaker. Amen. So when you get shaken, you're releasing salt.
Yes, sir.
By somebody looking at you.
That's right.
That's right.
Somebody's looking to see how you respond to that shake.
That's right.
Amen.
That's good.
Hallelujah. Sometimes, praise God, the salt won't come out the shaker. You got to unscrew the top. Amen. And release it.
Yeah.
And you gotta be careful with that. You put too much salt.
Yeah.
Amen. Praise God.
Amen.
And so we have a great responsibility to be salt in the earth and light in darkness.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
Praise God. Hallelujah. Again, it was a tremendous word. You blessed us tonight.
Amen.
You just fed off the anointing that was here today, and
amen.
Praise God, and God, engulf you with that anointing for tonight.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Tremendous word. Praise God. Let's stand. We're going to praise God. We're going to pray, and we thank God for all of you that are here. We pray for the sick. Amen.
Yes.
Praise God. Y'all pray for my little grandson, and he has the flu. Amen. Pray for little man.
Amen.
Hallelujah. That's the only thing that can take him down. Praise God. If not, he would have been here. Amen. But I thank God that he's out of school this week. Get a chance to rest up and recover from that. Amen. We pray for him. Any other prayer concerns tonight, we thank God for. Keep praying for your uncle. Your uncle name?
Curtis Tolliver.
Oh, yeah. Amen. Curtis Tolliver.
Layla. 810 baby. It's a friend of mine.
Amen.
Grandbaby in the hospital. I don't know what she's gotten out yet, but keep on the prayer.
Okay. Layla, Brother Tolliver, Leonard, the little man.
George.
Jordan and Joy. Amen. Praise God. Praise God. Hallelujah. Let's pray for Mr. Tolliver. Let's pray for Layla. Let's pray for Leonard. Let's pray for Jordan and Joy. And anyone else that God lays upon your heart tonight. Amen. Hallelujah. And Father, we just thank you, Lord,
for the richness of your word. Hallelujah. Not only, Lord, does your word save and deliver, but your word also heals. So, Father, we just release a healing word, a delivering word tonight. To Mr. Tolliver tonight, we lift him up, oh God. We pray for him right now. That whatever that need is, God, you would meet it in the name of Jesus. We pray for Jordan Carter to be healed, God, from his flu. We speak to his immune system, God, to be strong and fight off every infection in the name of Jesus. We cover him under the blood. We pray for Jordan Williams tonight that you would continue to keep him, oh God, and continue to favor him, God, as he endeavor, as he goes through, God, another rite of passage, as he goes through another phase and transition in his life. We pray favor upon him in the name of Jesus. And Father, I pray that you would keep him strengthened and keep him encouraged, oh God. In Jesus' name, we pray. We pray for Layla, Lord. We pray for this young baby. We pray for this child, oh God. Oh God, nothing touched the heart like a sick child, a sick baby. So Father, we just cover her under the blood tonight. And God, that you would grant healing, oh God, in the name of Jesus. You said healing is a children's prayer. Father, so we lift her up tonight in the name of Jesus. She's innocent. It's not her fault. God, she's not to blame. But God, we just rebuke the devourer right now. Say to the Lord, rebuke you off this baby in the name of Jesus. And Father, we speak healing over her in Jesus' name. We speak healing over Leonard tonight. And God, you grant him a miracle. He needs another miracle. You granted him a miracle that he did not die in the accident. Now grant him another miracle and restore his body. In the name of Jesus, we speak the word. We release the word to go forth and heal. In every situation, God, we speak the word over Mr. Tolliver. We speak the word over Layla. We speak the word over Jordan and Jordan. We speak the word over Lynn. We speak the word. Hallelujah. Over every family that's been touched by the devil. Oh, God, we hate the devil. We hate everything he stands for. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord, right now. Oh, God. That you are still God. Oh, my God. When you change not. And we worship you tonight. We thank you, Lord. God, that you have commissioned us. You have commanded us to be salt in the earth.
Hallelujah.
In the name of Jesus. I thank you, Father.
Thank you.
I thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah. Thank you.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
In the name of Jesus.
Oh, glory to God. Glory to God. I give you the praise. I give you the glory. Bless us as we leave this place is our prayer. In Jesus' name.
Jesus' name.